fact, it is not the language for linguistics, it is the language for planning and strategy for a commonwealth of Islamic propagation center. Those in Africa are needy people, going to the church for the piece of cloth and some rice to eat and little water to drink. This is the first achievement of the church, not by any other language or by religious or spirituality. If we have all extravagant, either rich or even what we call them poor, out of our saving, we can help Africa, a Muslim, by helping them against poverty, against illiteracy, against also all type of disease which is spread. So what is the plan of the Islamic Propagation Center of Al-Azhar, of the Rabat al-Arab Islami, in order to cover the name and achieve this achievement? Have you been talking in a seminar or a conference in this respect? Thank you.
Brother, the Rabita is doing its job, and Al-Azhar is doing its job. Everybody, body and society, they are doing the job. Everybody, we need more and more. The Christians have got 1,000 different churches and denominations, and everybody is doing the job. The Muslims now, you want to pass the buck. The tabligi jamaat. You know the tabligi jamaat? Why don't they do this? Deedat, why don't you do that? You so-and-so Rabita, why don't you do that? This is a very easy way out for all of us. We are cowards by nature, all of us. We want to pass the buck, pass the responsibility onto somebody else. I am not interested in this body, that body, that body. I am interested in you. 90% of my people, the Muslims of the world, are doing nothing. 90% are doing nothing. They are all armchair critics. I want you to get involved. Don't start looking for excuses. Passing the buck to Al-Azhar, they have their faults. They have their shortcomings. Everybody seems to have some shortcoming. Me too, I have my shortcomings. But I want you to all get involved. And for that, get my books, these booklets of mine, to arm yourself against this Christian onslaught. Right throughout the world, they're stealing our children. They are boasting today that they have perverted more Pakistanis into Christianity since independence in the previous 100 years of British rule. They have perverted 1 million Bangladeshis, more than what they ever did in the previous 100 years. They have done it since independence. They have perverted 15 million Indonesians into Christianity. And by the turn of the century, they are promising that they'll make Indonesia a Christian nation. Every sign shows that they will succeed. Now, I want to arm my brothers how to defend yourself against this Christian onslaught. There are so many other shortcomings. I said, look, there are different people doing a different job. You might choose a role to help the community in some other field. You might be a black belt karate expert. So it's right, I want to teach everybody karate. It's right, with my blessings, go and teach everybody karate. Get the young men and teach them karate. Every Muslim, once a guy has got the hat, nobody will ever touch you. He said, this guy may be a black belt karate expert. Everyone, this is your uniform. Everybody's got this humble topi. He said, hey, don't touch him. Don't touch him, like the Japanese. You'll be terrified to touch a Japanese. Why? Because the reputation, karate, karate. Out of how many million Japanese, how many know karate? A handful. Do you know that? But the reputation, the Japanese, if you just, you want to fight, and you're sure in your pants. You know that? Reputation. What is your reputation? What is our reputation? We are like punching bags. Everybody's attracted to come along and practice on you. Huh? The shit on your head. That's our reputation. I said, look, you, my brother, and anybody else, I want you. What are you prepared to do? Forget Al-Azhar, forget the Rabita, and forget IPC. What are you prepared to do for Islam in this field? That's all. Next question.